there is a significant risk of human extinction from advanced AI systems.
I love the technologies. I would like to create such kind of technologies to contribute to the human and human society. Even the brain nerve systems can be connected to the cyberspace.
This is a rapidly evolving technology. People do not know how it currently works, much less how future systems will work. We don't really have ways yet to make sure that what's being developed is going to be safe.
This AI recognizes human being also the one of the important living things.
This very small group of people are developing really powerful technologies we know very little about.
People's concerns about generative AI wiping out humanity stem from a fear that if left unchecked, AI could potentially develop advanced capabilities and make decisions that are harmful to humans. As the world grapples with the implications of this rapidly evolving field, one thing is certain: the impact of AI on humanity will be profound.
With new AI technologies, you can realize a fusion between the human side and technology side. This one is the world's first wearable cyborg. Cyberdyne trying to create the very innovative cybernetics technologies, especially focusing on the medical and healthcare fields for the human and human societies. My name is Yoshiyuki Sankai. So I'm a professor of University of Tsukuba, Japan, and also the CEO of Cyberdyne. Let's create the bright futures for the human and human societies with such kind of AI systems.
I personally want to have an impact on making the world better, and working on AI safety certainly seems like one of the best ways to do that right now. Many public intellectuals, many professors, scientists across industry and academia recognize that there is a significant risk of human extinction from advanced AI systems. We've seen in recent years rapid advancements in making AI systems more powerful, bigger, more generally competent, and able to do complex reasoning. And yet, we don't have comparable progress in safety guardrails or monitoring or evaluations or ways to know that these powerful systems are going to be safe. My name is Gabriel Makobi, or Gabe, you can call me. I'm a grad student at Stanford, and I do AI safety research, and I lead Stanford AI Alignment.
AI has become such a divisive topic. There are a lot of valid concerns. Some believe it could lead to job losses, increased inequality, and even unethical uses of AI. However, AI also has tremendous potential to benefit humanity. It could help us tackle some of the world's biggest problems, such as climate change, disease, and poverty.
How detects the very important human's intention signals from the brain to the peripherals? If the human wish to move, then the brain generates intention signals. These intention signals transmitted through the spinal cord, motor nerve to the muscle, then finally we can move. How systems and humans always work together. 20 countries now use these devices as a medical device.
I think there's definitely great ways AI technology is used in medicine. For example, there's cancer detection that's possible because of image recognition systems using AI that allows for detection without invasive tests, which is really fantastic, and early detection as well. No technology is inherently good or evil. It's only humans who are doing this. Of course, we should be thinking about long-term impact in terms of the direction which we're taking the technology. But at the same time, we also need to think about it less in a technical sense and more in terms of it impacting real-life humans today.
maybe the top use case of AI will be making money. You might see a lot of people being defrauded of money. You might see a lot of attacks on public infrastructure, threats against individuals in order to extort them. It could be a wild west of digital cyber attacks in the coming years. Beyond that, though, there is a pretty big risk that AI systems could actually get out of the control of their developers. We don't currently know how to steer these systems, how to make sure that they robustly understand in the first place, or even follow human values once they do understand them. They might learn to value things that are not exactly aligned with what we want as humans, like having Earth be suitable for life on it, or making people happy.
My vision is a little bit different. We could create the AI systems. This one is the one newly created species, I think. Generative AI system is different from the simple programming systems. It has a growing up functions. This AI recognizes human being also the one of the important living things, like one of the animals. And because the human is also one of the living things, they recognize the importance of the humans. They try to keep our societies, our cultures, and circumstances. We human beings have some problems, aging problems, or disease and accident. AI systems, or some technologies with AI systems, will support the some functions.
A lot of the startups that are at the leading edge of AI, so that's OpenAI, Anthropic, Inflection, names you might not yet be familiar with, they are backed by some of the big companies you already know that are at the top of the stock market. So that's Microsoft, Amazon, Meta, Google. And, you know, these companies are based here, many of them in the Bay Area. So for all of the discussion that we've seen about AI policy, there's actually very little that tech companies have to do. A lot of it is just voluntary. So what we are really depending on as guardrails is the benevolence of the companies themselves.
You have to realize that unlike some other very general technologies that have been developed in the past, AI is mostly being pushed, especially the frontier systems, by a small group of scientists in San Francisco. And this very small group of people are developing really powerful technologies we know very little about. Some of this maybe comes from a lot of historical techno-optimism among especially the startup landscape in the Bay Area. A lot of people are kind of used to this move fast and break things paradigm that sometimes ends up making things go well. But as is the case, if you're developing a technology that affects society, you don't want to move so fast that you actually break society.
Pause AI wants a global and indefinite pause on the development of frontier artificial general intelligence. So we're putting up posters so that people can get more information. No, the AI issue is complicated. A lot of the public does not understand it. A lot of the government does not understand it. You know, it's really hard to keep up with the developments. Another interesting thing is that most of us working on this have no experience in activism. What we have mostly is like technical knowledge and familiarity with AI that makes us concerned. AI safety is still very much the minority. And then actually a lot of the biggest AI safety names are working at AI labs, you know. I think some of them do great work, but they're still much more under the influence of the broader, you know, corporation that's driving toward development. I think that's a problem. I think that somebody from the outside ought to be telling them, like, what they need to do. And unfortunately, the case with AI now is that, like, there aren't external regulatory bodies that are really up to the task of regulating AI.
Obviously, at some literal level, maybe you can unplug some advanced AI systems, and there are definitely a lot of hopes. People are trying to actively make it easier to do that. Some of the regulation now is focused on making sure that data centers have some good off switches, because currently a lot of them don't. In general, this might be more tough than people realize in the future. we might be in a state in the future where we have pretty advanced AI systems widely distributed throughout the economy, throughout people's livelihoods. Many people might even be in relationships with AI systems, and it could be really hard to convince people that it's okay to unplug some widely distributed system like that.
What worries me a little bit more about this whole scenario is that AI technology doesn't necessarily need to be a tool for global capitalism, but it is. It's the only way in which it's kind of being developed. And so in that model, of course, we're going to be repeating all the kind of things that we've already done in terms of empire building and people being exploited, natural resources being extracted. All these things are going to repeat itself because AI is only another kind of thing to exploit.
I think a reasonable world where people are making sure that emerging technologies are safe is necessarily going to have a lot of safeguards and monitoring. Even if there's a small risk, it seems pretty good to try to mitigate that risk further to make people more safe.
Peace and the military side are very near. I carefully consider how to treat it. So when I was born, there is no AI systems and there's no computer systems. But the current situations, the young people start their life with AI and robots and so on. Some technologies with AI will support their growing up processes.
People have been pretty bad about predicting progress in AI. 10 years in the future, there might be even wilder paradigm shifts. People don't really know what's coming next. But I suppose David beat Goliath. There's still some chance.
The vast majority of AI researchers are focused on building safe, beneficial AI systems that are aligned with human values and goals. While it's possible that AI could become super intelligent and pose an existential risk to humanity, many experts believe that this is highly unlikely, at least in the near future.